My name is Vahid Chitsaz, part of Elite Mastermind Group. Thank you for being here this morning, this afternoon. Go ahead and introduce yourself to everybody. Let us know where you're tuning in from.
I am Dina Friedman. I am with the Summers team in Keller Williams here in Philadelphia.
What's up with this Philadelphia people, man? I've been doing a lot of sessions with people from Philadelphia. I guess everybody decided to just reside there. The last I've done, I'm not joking, I've probably done like
Just
six or
stay on
seven.
the
Yeah, I guess so. You guys all love to be on IG. Fantastic. So listen, I got a question for you.
Sure.
What are the two things that you love about real estate? And what is the two things you don't like about real estate?
Great question. So I love real estate because it's a really great channel and avenue of wealth. You can create wealth. You don't have to have a lot of money to get into real estate. And the other thing I love about real estate is anyone can do it. You can be 18 or you can be 85. So those are two things I absolutely love about real estate. Two things that are a little challenging, I would say, the rules aren't always the same in every single city and state. So here in Philadelphia, we do have one of the highest transfer tax. So if you are buying or selling real estate, you have to pay this transfer tax. And like I said, it's one of the highest. So in Philadelphia, it's 4.2%, so which is split between the buyer and the seller. Whereas if you go and buy real estate, say in Pennsylvania County, outside, maybe in like Bucks County or Montgomery County, that's only 2%. So it's a big difference in the amount of money you pay in transfer tax. And the other thing I probably don't like about real estate, I would say, being I own property myself, investments, you know, it can be challenging. You know, it's not a guarantee. Things will come up, spare the moment, you know, you'll have a hole in the roof or, you know, a tenant calling you about an issue. So anything is possible in real estate. Every day
I
is
mean,
different.
Listen, that's what makes it fun. If there was no challenge, if there was no phone calls, it would be like, you know, I don't know. To me, it's like that's kind of part of the game.
It keeps me on my toes for sure.
Being successful entrepreneur, doesn't matter what field you're in. What are a couple of suggestions that you could let us have that has helped you so far in your journey?
I would say absolutely have a big why. Know why you're getting into entrepreneurship. Write it down. Look at it every day. There are going to be some days that you're going to pop out of bed, and there's going to be some days that you crawl out of bed or want to throw the sheets back over your head. So just, you got to go back to that. Why am I doing this? Why am I getting up? What's the point of it? Because every day will challenge you. That's definitely helped me get through some of the rough days or the tough clients or the difficult, you know, tasks at hand. So definitely having a really big why, and, you know, don't think small, think big, you know, whatever you think you can accomplish, times that by 10, times it by 100, you know, the sky is the limit. You know, don't live in fear. I've been hearing that a lot, and I totally believe it. A lot of times when we're nervous to do something different or to challenge ourselves, usually the limiting factor is our fear. We don't want to make the phone call, or we don't want to take the step forward, or we don't want to apply for that job, or try a new business. It's our own fear that's holding us back. So, you know, be brave, step forward, leap, do it.
No, you should have been a motivational speaker. What's up with real estate? Forget about real estate. You're in the wrong field. You need to change your life.
Thank you.
So here's my other question. How do you keep yourself? I don't like to use the word motivation, because some people have different understanding or a historical vision of what motivation is. But what keeps you inspiring and motivating to push forward? What are some of the methods that you're utilizing today?
I know. My family, you know, the life that I want to live, that I want to provide, you know, I start my day with gratitude. You know, what am I grateful for? What do I have? And then saying, I can do it. and just, I'm going to do it. I'm not going to try. I'm not going to attempt at it. You know, I'm going to put it on a to-do list. No, I'm going to do it. And even if I can just do one thing, like, that's a win. And you have to celebrate the small wins, because over time, it totally adds up. When I look back to, you know, 5-6 years ago, when I was just getting into real estate, you know, it seemed so challenging and so overwhelming. You know, I'm new. I don't know anything. How am I ever going to make it? How am I ever going to live on a commission-based, you know, salary, which I had never done before? I had always had, you know, a steady salary. So how am I going to go 100% commission? Oh my God, what if I don't do it? What if I fail? And then it was like, but what if you succeed? What if you win? And what if you win really big? And that's been the most exciting part, is that I don't have those limits on me anymore. I can't only make $100,000 a year. You know, I can't only, you know, work 8 hours a day. You know, I limit myself as to what I can and want to do and accomplish. So
how did you get over that fear? That was a very important point. What helped you get over that? Because I think a lot of individuals are stuck at that.
Yeah. And it's all mindset. You know, I have some really amazing people in my circle. You know, I also have some really great books. I know you're a big avid fan of Think and Grow Rich. That's like my bedside Bible. You know, I have another girlfriend who wrote a book, The Power of Positive Thinking. You know, if I have, like, literally saved on my phone, like, the first 5 people are like my go-to people. If I'm having a bad day, like, I'm going to call or text them and they're going to help, like, pump me up. And I think that when we get, like, fearful and we have those moments, like, it's okay to be vulnerable and it's okay to ask for help, because we're not alone. We're human. It happens to all of us, you know, and we're going to feel so much better if we, like, recognize that and come up with a solution rather than just dwell on, you know, oh, I'm scared. Maybe I shouldn't do this. Maybe I'll wait till tomorrow. Maybe I shouldn't share this idea. Like, no, like, I think this is a good idea. You know, like, let me share it with someone who's going to be supportive. So many times, you know, we want to share it maybe with a loved one, and they might not be the best supportive, you know, person in our circle. So, you know, you need to go to the people who you know are going to support you. And even if it's a dumb idea, they're going to be like, yeah, I think it's crazy, but do it. I believe in you. Do it. You know, sign up for that thing. Go for that run. Go for that big challenge. Like, I'll be your cheerleader. You definitely totally have to identify who are the haters and who are the lovers. And when you have those vulnerable moments and those really, like, fearful spots where you're like, I don't know if I can do this, like, call those cheerleaders. Call them out. Say, hey, I'm having a rough day. I really need you to support me. This is going to sound crazy, but this is what I'm thinking about doing. And unless it's something like you absolutely shouldn't do, like suicidal, they're going to be there and they're going to be like, go for it.
I mean, so here's my question. By reading the book, I mean, Napoleon Hill said it a long time ago before I picked it up and I said it to other people. And none of this stuff is mine. I just copy other people, because success principles have been around for many, many, many years, thousands of years. So we don't need to reinvent them. I just transfer it through me so somebody else could hear it possibly and implement it. When you talk about Napoleon Hill, Think and Grow Rich, he talks about in there that most people are not successful or will not be successful because their surroundings are not successful, or they have a limiting beliefs, and AKA comes in a form of mom, dad, cousin, brother, sister, husband, girlfriend, boyfriend, all of these different individuals that might, they love you, but they may not be the best person to give you business advice. So my question is this, how did you build that circle of 5 people? One, and if you don't have those 5, how do you start working towards getting your 5? Because you're kind of building your own team. You're building your own cheerleaders. You're building your own coaches. How do you do that?
So I'm really fortunate. You know, I have a really awesome success group around me. But essentially, I look at who has stuff that I want, who has a successful business, who drives the car that I want, who lives in the house that I want. You know, who's doing the things that I want, who's going on the vacations that I want. Those are the people I want to emulate. And, you know, you're the sum of the 10 people that you surround yourself with the most. So if you're the smartest person in the room, get out of that room. Go into another room where you can learn from smarter, you know, more sophisticated, more, you know, experienced people. And I've never been, you know, shy to ask. You know, if someone were to come up to me and be like, hey, I have a question about real estate, like, and I can share with them some of my knowledge and I can empower them, like, absolutely. Because guess what? I'm going to feel really good about sharing. You know, it kind of, the more you give, the more you actually get back. And I'm a big believer in karma. You know, you do the right things and you put out the good energy and it's going to come back like times 10 to you. So if you're not sure, you know, where to find those people, look at who are you reading? Who are you watching? What are you, you know, bringing into your body, mind? And who has kind of those things that you want and those things that you want to emulate and you want to become? And it might not be your mom and dad, and that's totally okay. You know, my mom and dad were not entrepreneurs, so it was really hard sometimes, you know, to talk about things like not getting paid for 3 months and you still have to pay your bills. So what are you going to do? You know, so I really leaned on people in my profession and people that were really successful in their professions, you know, and said, how are you doing this? What are some things that you're doing? What are the habits? You know, what are you doing every day? And I think that's something that not a lot of people see. We see like the tip of the iceberg. We see the success and the money and the cars and the glamour, but we didn't see everything below it, that they had to struggle, that uphill battle of everything that they had to do, the blood, the sweat, the tears, the long nights, time away from family or kids, vacations that they didn't take, you know, because they were saving up for something bigger and better, you know, and that struggle is really ugly and not pretty and not glamorous. But you have to hear those stories, and no one's going to tell you unless you ask. So if you ask those really successful people, how did you get in the chair that you're in, you know, and are willing to be vulnerable with them and be like, I'm struggling right now and I need to hear a success story and I need kind of a guidance to that this is normal and it's okay to struggle and it's okay for it to be hard. So think about, you know, who do you want to emulate in terms of wealth? Who do you want to emulate in terms of intelligence and mindset? And who do you want to emulate in terms of lifestyle? You know, some people, it's not about money. It's about time. Can't ever get time back. So when you see those people that can really leverage their business to be able to take a vacation for a month, that might be way more important to you than driving a Maserati. So find out from that person, how are they leveraging, you know, what are some key facts that they really need? One thing that I really reflected on in my business this year was, in order for me to get better, I needed to be more accountable. So I hired a coach, you know, a business coach, someone that I was going to check in with and have to tell them goals. And if I didn't meet those goals, man, I was going to be so embarrassed. You know, the other thing I did was I took a really hard look at my finances and I stepped up and hired, you know, an awesome CPA, because I did not have the time, nor did I enjoy doing all the bookkeeping I needed to do for my business. And it was totally getting, you know, put to the fifth or sixth task. And that was so important. And that was one of the first things my coach made me do. She said, you're running a business. You need to know the numbers. You need to hire like a super awesome CPA that's going to be able to guide you and see what's coming ahead. So those were two huge investments I made in myself and in my business. And it can be really hard because that's a dollar that I'm putting out that I don't have a guarantee that I'm going to get back. But if I believe in me and I believe in my big why, every dollar I'm putting out, I'm only going to get it back times 10. So that's just my mindset that I've been really focusing on. So if anyone that's looking or struggling to find those five awesome people you surround yourself with, you know, write down kind of what are some of your goals and look to see who do you know, or even who don't you know, but who can you find on social media that emulates that, and make, ask them to be part of their goal. Pick their brain and try and get them to be in touch with them, even if it's a conversation.
I agree with that. So here's my question. Can you fail in real estate if you make 200 phone calls per day?
Yeah, you can absolutely fail. But you're failing forward. Well, hopefully you learn. What did you say wrong? You know, hopefully you're reflecting on it. Hopefully you're providing some worthwhile knowledge, right?
Let's say you learn it, you adjust it, you modify it, you make it better. Can you fail if you make 200? If you, I don't want to say you talk to 200 because not everybody might be available, but if you're building that stamina to be able to do 200 contacts per day, can you fail in real estate?
It's really hard. You know, like if you, it's not about just doing it one time though. You can't make 200 phone calls one day and be like, oh,
no, I'm talking about daily, five days a week. That is your job. That is part of your duty. Can you fail?
It's really hard. You'd have to be pretty much a bonehead. You know, if you're trying, you know, someone, you know, told me every no is a call closer to a yes. So, you know, you just have to keep going. You know, if you're trying and you're learning from every phone call, you know, like that fear you're pushing aside and you're just moving forward, it's going to be really hard for you to say you failed.
I agree with that 100%. If people want to get into real estate, what is the one key element that you think has helped you so far? What is that one tip that you think kind of helped you get over the first stage and have, you know, the successes rolling in?
You gotta find a mentor. One of the best things I ever did was I put myself out there and I connected with someone who was super successful already in real estate. And I was able to shadow her and mentor her. You know, I even worked part-time for her while I got my real estate license. So I got to see the good, the bad, and the ugly into what I was getting into. And once I was licensed, I was running. So many people want to go to school. They want to read all the books. You know, you want to try and learn everything before you do it because you don't want to fail. And the fact of the matter is, in this industry and a lot of entrepreneurial industries, you just got to jump in and you got to learn as you swim. So if you are, you know, brave and you have a mentor, you're not going to fail because you're going to have someone that's going to be there to kind of guide you as you're doggy paddling through it all. So find a really good mentor.
How could people find you?
You can find me at DBF136. You will also see me featured in at the Summers Team and also at KW Philadelphia. So anyone that has any questions, I would love to help and empower you.
Awesome. Listen, thank you so much for taking this time and being with us. Hopefully we'll get to do more. Definitely stay safe.
I would love to. Thank you so much. It was great
to be part of it. You got it. Bye-bye.
Bye.